AI is reshaping our industry, which jobs are on the brink of disappearing, and which new roles are emerging. It can be a concerning thought if you're among the 2%. And the decision that you make can make or break your career. Imagine strolling through a futuristic city where automated cars zoom by and holographic billboards light up the sky. It almost feels like a scene from a sci-fi movie, doesn't it? But here's the exciting part. Considering the current pace of development, this futuristic vision could become a reality sooner than you think. If you're new here, I'm Jane, your trusted engineering mentor. Today, I'm here to help you navigate the ever-changing landscape of AI so you can make informed decisions about your career that align with the future. I was also an engineering manager at Facebook, now Meta, and an early engineer at WhatsApp. With over 15 years of experience working in tech, I have witnessed the highs and lows of tech industry. We're going to first dive into the global job outlook for the next 5 years. We'll also explore which jobs are likely going to thrive in the age of AI and machine learning, which jobs are going to fade away. Then towards the end, I'm going to share some practical decision-making framework to help you make informed choices in light of future trends. These are some common questions that I've been getting on YouTube and on LinkedIn. So if you have similar questions, feel free to ask me in the comments and hopefully I'll create videos around them. Let's get started with the global outlook of jobs and skills over the next 5 years. During my research for my last video on how to become a machine learning AI engineer, I came across the Future of Jobs 2023 report. It's from the World Economic Forum, and according to this report, the rising cost of living and the slower economic growth will drive significant transformations in top companies worldwide in the next 5 years. In 2022, global inflation hit a high of 8.8%, which is quite a jump compared to the pre-pandemic rate of 3.5%. Additionally, the International Monetary Fund, the IMF, projects economic growth to slow down to 2.9%, falling below the long-term average of 3.8%. The report highlights that factors like slower global economic growth, supply shortage, and an increased cost of living are all expected to displace jobs significantly in the future. And speaking from my own experience too, I live in San Francisco, and recently I grabbed a small rice bowl from a food truck and a soft drink, and it came out to be $25 plus tip. Prices in the Bay Area are pretty crazy, and it doesn't appear to be slowing down anytime soon. The world is getting more connected, and more businesses are going to be impacted by global trends. Now, let's dive into the exciting part, job outlook. The labor market churn is a term that might sound really fancy, but it's simply about how fast jobs are changing. In the next 5 years, approximately 23% of all jobs will be replaced. Remember my previous video about how AI could impact software engineers? There was a lot of comments debating exactly what jobs are coming. Over the next 5 years, 83 million jobs will vanish. But they're also creating 69 million new ones. We're left with 14 million fewer jobs overall, which is only 2% of all jobs worldwide, but it can be a concerning thought if you're among the 2%. So what are the top 5 roles that are expecting substantial growth in the near future? These jobs are like the shooting stars in the job market. Well, number 1 was AI and machine learning specialist, no surprise. Number 2 was sustainability specialist, followed by business intelligence analyst, information security analyst, and lastly, fintech engineers. It's no surprise that AI and machine learning specialists take the top spot. They're like the MVPs of the job market right now, right? And if you're thinking that you also want to become an AI or machine learning engineer, you should really watch my other video, AI/ML Engineer's Path. Breaking into AI or machine learning engineering without a PhD can be pretty challenging. But don't worry, I lay out how you can approach this in that other video. So now back to our list. Sustainability specialist was number 2 because of all the climate change and environmental issues that will be increasingly important in the next 5 years. Also, lots of business intelligence analysts and information security analysts will be needed because with a lot of data, we need more analysts to make sense of them. Number 5 is fintech engineers, which is an interesting one because on the top 5 highest rate of loss roles is bank tellers and related clerks. Now, I don't even remember the last time I went into a bank in person. I use the bank apps for everything nowadays. So it's no wonder that bank tellers are on the list of jobs that are decreasing, whereas the demand for fintech engineers is increasing. And here's the story. One of my friends used to work at a bank, but she made a smart move. She went to a data bootcamp. She became a data analyst at another bank. It shows that you can adapt to these changes if you just stay on top of things. Number two is postal service clerks, probably because a lot of their work can be automated. And you know those self-checkout machines at the stores? Well, those are going to be replacing cashiers and ticket clerks, which is number three. I guess this list is all about automations. If you're a data entry clerk, big data specialists are also on the rise, and you can probably learn some new skills and transition into this new role. So upskilling is really going to be important in the future for a lot of jobs. Number five is administrative and executive secretaries, because these jobs are also getting automated with a lot of productivity tools. As I finished reading this report, I got curious how they found all this information, so I did some digging. And here's what I found in the fine print of the report.
The Future of Jobs survey was conducted in late 2022 and early 2023, bringing together the perspective of 803 companies collectively employing more than 11.3 million workers across 27 industry clusters and 45 economies from all world regions. The survey covers questions of macro trends and technology trends, their impact on jobs, their impact on skills, workforce transformation strategies, business plan to use.
Okay, a lot of fancy words here. I don't know if you understood that fully, but I asked ChatGPT to explain this in easier words. And this is what it said. In a big survey, companies from around the world were asked about the future of jobs. About 803 companies with more than 11.3 million workers share their thoughts. They talked about important trends and how technology is changing work. So in a nutshell, the World Economic Forum went around and asked these big companies for their opinion on what future jobs would look like. And I guess that's how trend reports are usually done. Even weather forecasting is scientific, using historical weather data, patterns, and mathematical models to predict the future weather conditions. But how accurate is the weather forecast really? All they can do is predict the probability of something happening. So even when we base predictions on hard data, there's still a level of uncertainty. And how accurate can we be when we're basing our prediction on just a bunch of people who work at large companies around the world? But let's talk about decision-making process. One approach to decision-making process is to trust your intuition. People who believe in this method say trusting your inner feelings and instincts, even when you lack concrete evidence, to guide you in the direction that feels right. It's about honing your intuition and gut feelings. Another theory that's pretty interesting is from Malcolm Gladwell. I am a big Gladwell fan. He says that since we're so bad at predicting the future, we should just be picking things at random. And the probability of success is not so much different from us making choices based on reason. While that may seem a little extreme, there are also other theories, like a perspective from a Buddhist monk that I follow, Pomyun. He believes that when you're torn between two choices, it's often because they're quite similar. If one choice was significantly better than the other, you wouldn't be in a dilemma. So it might make sense to go with the easiest option since the outcomes won't be that different. And then there's the method of analyzing your options using numbers and rankings and spreadsheets, which is an option that we cover in our Exaltitude curriculum, because I love numbers and spreadsheets and data. I do find it valuable to complement the analytical method with the other methods. Well, let me know in the comments which method you think is the best. When it comes to your career, here's the key takeaway. You don't want to get too fixated on the trends and news, thinking that data science is the only path because it's trending. It's not that simple. Now, one of the pages on the report talks about the expected impact of technology on jobs in the next 5 years. So there's a long list of technologies they expect to see growth. Now you can see all those items in the blue growth area, which means the probability of these jobs working out in the future is bigger. So look through the list and pick the ones that sound interesting to you. And that's partly how I decided to work at WhatsApp. When I joined WhatsApp, which is a mobile messaging app, if you're not familiar with it, I joined as the 19th engineer. I had no clue that it was going to get acquired by Facebook for $19 billion. I had no experience in mobile apps, but the company and the role sounded interesting to me, and I decided to give it a shot. Back when I was in college, smartphones did not even exist. In a way, the rapid changes that we're seeing with AI today is sort of similar to smartphones back in the days. And the decision that you make during a transformative time like this can make or break your career. When I first started at WhatsApp, someone came to me and asked me if I can take on a project that's related to Android. And I said, okay, sure. Even though I knew nothing about Android, I looked up the Google documentation, read through it, and it worked out okay for me. I mean, obviously, like in the midst of things, I was nervous, definitely. I wasn't sure, am I going to be able to pull this off? And I did have to work hard because I was basically teaching myself how to tackle this new technology. I'm not that special. I'm not a super genius. If you put your mind to it, you can do it. I also never thought I would be spending 8 years working at WhatsApp. When I first joined, I thought I'll give it a shot for a year or two. But I ended up staying longer, obviously because I wanted to, because I was still learning and growing and enjoying the work. And it doesn't hurt that it got acquired for $19 million, so payout was really great. But the point is that if you don't give things a shot, you'll never really know. Long-term decision-making can be pretty daunting. Making shorter-term choices can be much more manageable. So don't be afraid to try things out. You can always course correct, but you won't know if you need to change directions if you're not even driving. The future is a bit like game of chances. My high school golf coach used to say, you miss 100% of the shots you don't take. So why not roll the dice and give it a try? You'll never know if it'll work out unless you take the chance. And that's a wrap for today. Bye.